Guys, easy, guys. One at a time. I know everybody loves our podcast. It's from Shrooms to Skyland with Matthew and Hiram. We are here. All right. Yes. One question at a time. Guys, relax.
Episode 155
from Shrooms to Skyrim with Matt and Hiram.
It's like a car alarm.
From Shrooms to Skyrim with Matthew and Hiram.
This is some Shrooms of Skyrim with Matthew and Hiram featuring Shawn and Carlos. The show neither about Shrooms nor about Skyrim. Those are the motherfucking parameters. And this episode is brought to you by Sandbar, Coconut Grove, 3064 Grand Avenue, Miami, Florida, 33133, Home of the Fish Taco, Happy Hour, Monday to Friday, 3 to 7, Taco Tuesdays, Tacos Half Off. Sandbar, Coconut Grove. This episode also brought to you by The Last Carrot at 3133 Grand Avenue, Miami, Florida, 33133. They're open Monday through Saturday, 10:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Sundays from 11 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Family owned since 1975, your go-to place for fresh, wholesome eats. The Last Carrot. What up?
Baby.
Who was that? That was Carlos.
Have you been practicing?
That's yes, and weird middle America person. We're the middle of America. Whoa, we're the middle of America. No one cares about us. We're the middle of America. Whoa, we're the no one cares about us.
No one cares unless you're east or west.
Dude,
fuck the middle.
Have you seen? He's talking about a different middle. Have you seen?
You're talking about central?
Different middle.
Yeah.
Sean's like,
what middle are we? Middle Earth? What?
Yo, Sean is bamboozled now, bro. There's so many different.
Anything?
He's like, which middle?
No.
America.
No, middle America is anything that's not a major city. That's middle America.
I thought you meant like class wise.
I thought you meant like literally the middle like of America. Because I was like, yeah, no one gives a fuck about them.
Yeah, I mean, that's a big portion of them.
I mean, no
yeah.
one calls that middle America, they call that the Midwest.
Yeah, but the Midwest is the Midwest. We're talking about the Midwest.
The
literal. No, we're talking about the literal.
You're talking about the Midwest.
I want to know the exact.
We're the middle of America.
I want to know the exact.
We're the middle of America.
The center of America. Whoa. What town is the. Can you look this up? What town is the center?
But in relation to what? Hawaii or
no,
Alaska?
I just want to know, too, like in America, the center.
Yo,
like
no,
the fucking.
No, but in relation to Hawaii, like what are the parameters?
Hawaii. How the fuck is that the center if it's...
No, but that's part of America, right?
I know it's part of America, but that's far as fuck. I mean, like...
South Dakota.
We're the middle of America. South Dakota. We're the middle... Man, but
no,
that's...
No, the geographic center of the United States is in Kansas.
Hmm.
Well, apparently the geographical center of the U.S. lies in South Dakota in the town of Belle Fourche. About 20 miles of North Belle Fourche at latitude 44.5802.07622 north on longitude 10346.0283 west lies the exact geographical center location of the 50
See,
states
this is something I'd love
of
to know.
The U.S. The U.S. Coast Guard.
Read it again.
Yeah, yeah.
The Yamada. 44.5802.07622N.
Yo, that's crazy that I did a Google search and got something different. My
Kansas Google. Was the geographic. All right, before. All right, look. Look. In relation to what you said, the U.S. and the Geodetic Survey designated the center of the nation in South Dakota in 1959, resulting from the...
They didn't know shit back then.
The inclusion of Alaska and Hawaii as the states of the U.S. before the move in 1959, Lebanon, Kansas was the geographical center of the nation.
Lebanon, Kansas.
The exact center of this, the exact center is in a private pasture field. However, a monument marking the geographical center of the U.S. was constructed in the city.
Did you just say Lebanon?
Yo, imagine being a white dude looking like me and like
Lebanon, Kansas.
I'm from Lebanon.
But is it like Lebanon? Is it spelled like Lebanon?
Is it like ha, la, 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 Lebanon?
No, but see, that's the Middle East. Maybe they're onto something.
My husband is Walter White.
They're in the middle.
They're in the middle.
Uh-huh. There's two middles.
He told me everything.
Man, thank God you have that soundboard. I'm so relieved. Oh, that was good. Where is that from?
Man, when I'm
Breaking Bad.
Yo, my intrusive thoughts be brazy when I'm over caffeinated.
Yeah, I be risen too, or something. I don't know. I don't know what words mean anymore.
Rizzing is like game with a girl.
I don't have any of those things.
Yo, you wanna know something?
Yeah, they should do this game with Lil Wayne, and it's like Max Wayne, and he's all like. My family, baby. What happened to my family, baby? Max Wayne.
Max Wayne.
Just checking on my boss, cause I love you, dog. Yo, what's up?
Man,
I got my butt fucked this week. I'm just kidding. I got my shit pushed in this week. That's what happened.
Yeah. Isn't that the same as getting your butt fucked?
You ever have your shit fucked in your ass?
No, the guy came up to me. He's like, hey, I'm just going to push in your shit. I'm like, all right. You're not going to fuck me, are you? He's like, I'm just pushing in your shit.
Dude, like, I'm helping you
out. It's all about
out.
Words, and that's America.
That's semantics.
Cinematography.
That's a cinnamon topography.
It looks like a scene in Westworld.
Westworld. Westworld.
With my homies. I want a Westworld.
As opposed to Middle World.
So how was your week?
Yeah, let me tell you something, man. I don't know when it actually happened.
Like your week?
It started on Sunday.
That's not. But at some point this year, I just wanted to see after I felt all sounds drop off, I was like, "Yo, how long? Yo, the tension was brazy. Could you feel that? Could you feel that tension in the air?
Yeah, you like to do it a lot."
Sean's like, I gotta go cut out that.
At this point, I don't give a fuck anymore.
What tension? I have no idea what the fuck.
Yeah, no, it was like, yeah. It was,
you know,
like,
I've been,
no,
more like Carlos like, the past couple
like,
weeks.
It was like,
just
the,
like,
it was, no, the suspense when you guys were just waiting, and I was
yeah.
Yo, I don't, they're so focused on me. Like, it was like a,
can I be,
it was like, it was like a dopamine hit. Like, I was like, I want to keep this, I want to extend this moment.
Can I be completely honest with you?
No, you can be partially dishonest with me. How about that?
Oh, you're absolutely right. I was super excited and suspense-filled. I was on the edge of my seat. I was on the edge of my seat when waiting for what you were going to say. I knew I was going to be overwhelmed by what you were going to tell me.
I have become a full-fledged King of the Hill fan.
Fuck yeah.
Damn it, Bobby.
And because before, like, I would just like watch it, like, ironically.
It's a great show, though.
But I have cable now, and it just be on sometimes. And
you have cable?
Yeah, we've talked about this.
Oh, okay, I forgot.
It's it's included in everything that I pay for.
That's sick.
But like, it was just on passively, and then at some point I started paying attention, and also too, Cause it's a dude I follow on Instagram, a micro niche internet celebrity, Truly Red Panda. It's a great dude. We went to Instagram together.
Okay, wait. Do you know this person personally?
Nah, but
what's the name of the person?
Truly Red Panda.
Okay.
Fucking cool ass dude, but he's in the King of the Hill. He be posting a lot of King of the Hill memes. And that kind of made me start paying more attention to it. And then now I genuinely like it as opposed to when I just be ironically watching stuff.
He's got 15.3 thousand followers.
The show has a lot of hidden gems in it. That's
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And it's just like...
Because like at face value, when you're like watching it, you're kind of like, okay, this could be very bland.
It's not blatantly over the top like Family Guy or how The Simpsons got. But when you actually watch it, it's just like you just kind of get into it.
I've been watching a lot of Home Improvement.
I haven't watched that since I was a kid.
It makes me feel like a kid again. It's crazy.
And like the plots of King of the Hill, like they're just like, you know, like Peggy started working for Alamo Beer and then they stopped selling it in Texas. And she found out it's because like it was making people throw up and they're only selling it in Mexico. And she couldn't tell anyone because, you know, company secret. And, you know, Hank and them boys drove down to Mexico, get the beer, and they all got sick. And, you know, like this is though, you know.
Yeah.
It's just little plots like that, just like day-to-day stuff, you know, happening in Arlen, Texas. But it's just like it's, you know, when you actually watch King of the Hill, it's just like it's a very endearing show.
Yeah, I mean, if you love propane and you have propane needs,
propane and accessories. You want some
flapjack booty, I think Hank Hill has the best ass.
God damn it, Bobby. God damn it, Bobby.
Boomhauer is the shit. And Dale, best, Dale's bro. Hilarious, too. It's Boomhauer, Dale, and who's the other one?
This goes right here.
Oh, John Redcorn?
The one that be fucking Dale's wife. Well, actually, the season I'm on right now, she's actually she's discontinued her affair with John Redcorn, and she's 100% focused on Dale right now.
He's a real scumbag.
Who, Dale or John Redcorn?
John Redcorn.
Yo, he got pissed, though, when... Cause Hank hooked up the propane for Dale and Nancy's hot tub, and then he had a dream where he was grilling burgers naked, and Nancy was there, and
I remember that episode.
He was distraught. He told John Redcorn about it, and John Redcorn got A1 hot. He's like, "You had a dirty dream about my nan nan."
But she's with Dale.
Yeah.
Yo, fuck that guy. That guy's a fucking piece of shit. But Sir has that great song called John Redcorn. It's pretty sick.
Yeah, John Redcorn heard that and was like,
"Is that like a personal attack or something?"
All you can eat buffet over here, bro.
What? Yeah. Feels that way, huh? Bro, what the fuck, man? I hate this shit. I quit.
Did you already... You went through this?
Nah, yeah, bitch. I went through it. It's done.
Yo, is anyone keeping up with threads?
I'm sorry.
Is anyone on threads?
Don't worry. When I got some money...
No, no, Carlos. My no. God.
No, because I want to do that.
When you get some money, what?
Like, I want to bless people in my life with shit.
Yo, Sean's theme song for 2023 is wait till I get my money right. Because his money, his money been
wrong. I had a dream I could find my way to heaven. By my way to heaven.
Yeah.
But when I woke, I spent that on a necklace.
Yeah. It's like the main bar.
I told God I'll be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act
reckless.
I would do it to build.
Babe. Yeah, Sean, all year, Sean been like, wait till I get my tax return.
Wait till I get fined and pay off this.
IRS hit him with that Uno reverse.
They're like, oh, yeah.
Yo, you pay taxes, and then you pay taxes again, and then you pay taxes again, you pay taxes. So we pay taxes to the IRS, and then we pay taxes on the house that we already bought.
We also pay taxes on vehicles,
and then you pay taxes like when you go out and pay even more taxes on everything, and then you pay taxes for the road.
Let's just go to Austin, Texas, guys.
You pay tolls to go on the road that you already paid taxes to build.
But you can't do this to me.
Let's go to Austin, Texas. Joe Rogan knows what's up.
I think of Tim Robinson. I'm like, what the fuck did they do to us? What the fuck? What are we fucking thinking?
Austin, bro, let's go. Let's go to Texas.
Why? What happens in Texas?
There's no like state
King
tax.
Of the Hill.
Really?
There's no income tax. There's no state or income tax.
Really?
Yeah.
I think that's why Joe Rogan went there.
But if you're living, apparently if you live in an area that does have state and income tax for like a certain period of time, which would be us.
Well, Florida,
and you move
Florida
to an area.
Have an income tax. Oh, wait.
They have income tax. They don't have state tax.
Yeah, something.
If you move to an area that doesn't have either of the state or income, you still get a state tax from the area that you lived in.
What if you don't move to an area?
If you're a
move
resident?
To space.
If you're still a resident?
What if I just build a rocket ship and fly to space? Am I taxed on that?
Fucking chip, man. I work every day. I have no money. Fucking chip, man.
Yeah, I'm like really trying not to spend this paycheck, but there's so much to
this
spend.
This should
on.
Be from Shrooms to Broke podcast.
Yeah, that. Fucking.
You know what? Maybe we should talk about how broke we are. We never do that. And then we'll do that. And then we could be like, hey, if you guys really love this pod and love hearing about how broke we are and you don't want to hear it anymore, support us.
Pay us we'll to stop the podcast.
No,
pay
no.
us to just give it a quit.
No, pay us to just focus on being fun.
Hey, man. You know, Instagram let us monetize. Well, not monetize. They made it so that people could. We're eligible for people to send us tips on our reels.
Yo, dude, I'll fucking. OnlyFans that shit, bro.
Yo, if we put the gayest ones up, and then the guys will tip us,
like,
and I'll be all like,
"Boys,
I'll fucking what's up?"
I'm still gonna send it.
Is this what you want? And then probably not. That was disgusting, right? So bad. My body's gross.
Yeah, I see the.
My wife's like, "You're beautiful." I'm like, "You fucking liar." Sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, I seen a meme that was like, "Bro, if I thought that I could make 100,000 on OnlyFans, I would have so much stuff up my butt right now. You'd think I was a pest dispenser."
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know about ass play.
My ass?
No, I'm saying like shoving shit up your ass for OnlyFans. I don't know about that.
You talking about guys doing it?
Yeah.
Guys, but they want that?
We're all gentlemen in here.
People want to see that?
How low would you go to make $100,000 off OnlyFans? That's a good question.
I'll suck a dick.
That's okay.
$100,000? Suck a dick.
For $100,000? I don't know, bro.
$100,000? I'll suck a dick. No
to
problem.
To completion?
No.
So how long?
30 seconds.
30 seconds?
Yeah. And
you
be,
know what? 30
I'll
seconds, $100,000?
I'll look like, it'll look like a gay... I'll make it look like a gay scene. Like a straight up, like, I'm really enjoying it. Because I'm a good actor.
Like,
I'm a good actor, guys.
Well, you're going to have to, like, shave the beard and, like, pretty yourself up if you're going to be the bottom.
I just said I'll
suck the top.
I said I'll 30 seconds.
That's the top, though. So you have to, like.
What are you talking about? I'm doing. It's my terms. I don't know why you're trying to interject and try to create a.
You can't, with that beard and that outfit, be, like, actually compelling.
You want
sucking a dick.
He just what? I'm just saying I'll just look like I'll
you gotta
I'll
shave
sell
the beard.
It. I'll
you,
sell
you gotta
it.
Wax, you gotta wax the fucking face. You gotta like really trim up the eyebrows so they're pointy.
Wax his
face. Why does this have to do with anything?
You gotta do like I don't know.
What
like
would you do for a hundred grand?
On OnlyFans?
Yeah.
Like it has to be against my sexual preference.
It
whatever. Dude.
Or can it be with my sexual preference?
Whatever's.
Can I just fuck a girl? Can I say I'd fuck a girl for 100,000? I didn't have to go straight to sucking dick.
I set my boundaries, and it is a sucking. $100,000 is our automatic. Boom, sucking dick. Starting.
But
from
why
there.
Did you have to go the route that you don't prefer? Unless
I could I
because. Carlos,
I know what
like,
I'm willing to do. I know what I'm
Carlos
willing to
like,
do.
Carlos is like, I set my boundaries. None.
Because after $100,000, now we're talking about my butthole. You know?
That's 150.
So 102 grand.
Nah, man. We're going to multiple integers now. It's like a fundamental frequency and then the rest of the harmonic series.
Multiple integers for multiple entrances.
I guess we're using multiple entrances now. Yeah. I guess I'm willing to $1 million. I could get Eiffel Towered for $1 million.
See, but you know the reason.
But like, why haven't you said like, I don't know.
I thought you were going to say, why haven't you done it yet?
Yeah. I'm just letting you know what I'm willing to do for the money. So if anybody wants to hit me up and got $100,000 or $1 million and want this right here.
Yo, did you see that dude that's like supposed
this is definitely going to be a reel. I hope not, dude. Man, I hate everything I say. I regret. I
have Ma'am, it sounds like your car is having ignition issues.
Man, I kind of
bro. Are you okay? Are you okay, bro?
Woo!
I can't stop laughing. It's so funny, dude.
I
don't get it.
You didn't hear him like fucking 5 minutes ago trying to say supposed to?
He's
like
So, hey, can we watch the GTA?
Yes, please.
Trailer?
Please. He hasn't seen it. He saved his genuine reaction for this.
Yeah, we were like watching in the car and he's like trying to show me one. I'm about to fucking run into an 18-wheeler.
Bro, what are you talking about? This is you in the car the whole time just watching like drum tutorials as you're driving on the expressway.
I'm like,
you're like, bro, look at this guy, dude. You're like, bro, look at the. Yo, dude, have you seen this guy before? Not only are you looking at it, you're looking at it as it's like in front of my face. So you're like looking to the right.
That's good, right? Accept me. So they eat cat in certain countries.
Let me know where that is.
It's called squish.
Is that a soft meat?
Yeah, it's called squish.
Yo, you guys know who Ruby Rose is?
Yeah.
Have you seen the dude that
paid like, $90,000 on her OnlyFans?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then I don't know if all of this is real, but like they released his text messages to her.
Oh, that's
like,
fucked.
Like paragraphs.
Okay, so that's obviously just like it's like encouraging stalking in a sense.
But like I don't I don't even understand the dynamic. Like they had like a meetup, but it wasn't planned, and then like now he has a tattoo of her. I don't even care enough. Like, you know, I was reading it earlier. Like, I don't even care enough to read it because the text messages was like insane. He was like, yeah, "Is I don't know
what was he saying?"
Okay, fine. I'll look it up.
But like what?
No,
like,
GTA trailer.
Like
fuck
sit
that.
On my what? Like sit on my face or whatever.
It's OnlyFans shit. Obviously, he spent $90,000 on her OnlyFans in total.
Ruby Rose 90,000 desperate texts from number one OnlyFans spender that show him professing his love and getting tat of her. You know, look, I don't even know. Like when I googled her right now, it's like, oh, like she's like a rapper model. Like, I don't even know like who she is. But like supposedly, from what I was wearing on Instagram, like she's not even naked. You know what I'm saying?
Like it's like Instagram. Apparently, I don't have it.
Yo, you had to clear that up real quick.
No, I go for like the unknown ones. You know what I'm saying? The free subscribe for free. I'd be haggling them. They're like $4.99 for this 61 photo bundle. Hey, yo, drop that down to like $150 and I got you, bro.
Yo, that's what, isn't that what, like, Kanye said to do?
Bro, okay, can you open the door for this cat?
For the cat?
Yeah, my God.
That cat sucks, dude.
I know.
Should get rid of it. I'm just kidding.
Shut the fuck up, no, Squish!
Just leave it open. Just leave it open. There you go.
Such a dickhead. Your fucking dick, Squish.
Now, imagine that at 2 in the morning.
My God, I would fucking kill this cat, dude. And no, I would have figured it out.
Oh, what's
yo,
up?
Come up here. What do you want?
Don't be fooled. That cat is mean as hell.
Yeah, I know. Look at that, guys. Is this what you want? Look at the camera.
So cat butt. Okay, wait. I'm a show these.
He's got a spiky butt. He's got spikes on his butt.
Boy got hemorrhoids from all that fucking weight gaining, boy. I wanna know.
Where you at?
No. Not the cable to the camera.
Oh. Oh. Is it done? Oh. Is it stupid? No one's up. Trying to get a reaction
from you, baby. What the fuck did I just watch?
You don't have a spray bottle?
It doesn't work with him, bro. We sprayed him for a fucking year and a half.
He just walked around wet. He was just constantly wet.
He got used to it. He enjoys it. He's an impossible cat, bro.
He's like, yo, I'm fucking hot. Let me go knock something off the counter.
We go to the shelter to get a cat to, like, relieve stress. And then we get this fucker.
To relieve stress?
Oh, this yeah. motherfucker's huge. He's like the size of a medium sized dog. This cat.
His stomach like is about to hit the floor.
It looks like the Grinch, like Jim Carrey's the Grinch.
Yeah.
That's exactly how he's shaped.
He looks like a pear. He has like a pear shaped body.
My schedule won't allow it. All right, GTA, bro. GTA.
I'm gonna show these memes of the week, and then
bro, this is like Christmas when your mom has to make fucking coffee before you open the presents. That's what you're doing to me, bro. Have you experienced that?
He's like, nah, dude.
As the youngest person in the fam,
he had to go to work.
Everyone's like,
he had to go to work every Christmas morning.
Everyone doesn't want to wake up already. You've been up for like 4 fucking hours, just like waiting.
Classic middle America experience.
Matthew,
I mean, we were broke as fuck, but like Christmas was very special to me. So like I was up.
Your mom would be like, why are you awake? Oh my God, we have to put him to sleep. He keeps waking up every day.
Yo, if we're gonna do the video game thing, you gotta be leaving it on a more interesting screen than just the pause thing.
It's like, I thought we were gonna react. You're fucking throwing me off.
Oh, whoa. You want to play the blame game?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's my favorite game, dude.
Listen. I don't want to fight. Let's agree to disagree.
We're not making sounds for him anymore.
I was thinking of that, too. I must be sheltering Osama the way I
tally these bands.
Damn. Bro.
That's a bar. That's a fucking BLP kosher bar.
I must be sheltering Osama the way I be tallying these bands. Nah, I said it wrong.
Damn, look at that picture of me.
Nice, dude. What else are you showing us? Oh, shit.
Oh, man, that was unintentional. I feel exposed here.
What's up? I don't know if you guys can hear it, but it's a great meow.
Meow, meow.
A lot of bass behind it.
Smoking bass.
Oh, man, I really.
Yeah, just, like, bunch up all the cables, too, Squish. Yeah.
All right, so the next meme, got it right here, man.
What is the best loophole that you've ever found?
It's from a Reddit question. What's the best loophole that you ever found?
My brother once yelled, last one to jump in the pool is gay, and then jumped into the pool. However, I figured out that if I did not jump in, then technically he would be the last one in the pool, and he is still gay to this day.
Gotcha, bitch. GTA?
Yeah.
Nice.
Last one.
Oh, I thought this was GTA.
You guys already seen this one.
When you're tag teaming a girl and your homeboy says, "Now put it in me, bro." He looks so appalled. What?
And it's the subtitle too. Jazz music stops.
Oh
god.
All right, so the GTA trailer.
And let's just like fucking sauce this whole thing up real quick.
Sauce it up.
We've been waiting for this moment. At least I have.
You have.
Since like really.
Since 5 dropped. You've been waiting for 6.
No. I would say after 5 dropped, it kept me occupied for like 2 years. And then the remaster dropped. That kept me occupied. And then online also kept me occupied. Also, Red Dead Redemption 2 came out.
You was like,
everyone's like, yo, we've been waiting for this.
Basically, like, you was like Palestine.
Wow. Nah.
You was occupied.
Nice.
But really, I've been waiting for this reveal for like, I'll say almost 10 years exactly. It's been 12 years since the last one. Or 12 years and then it'll drop because it drops in 2025.
Which would you say is the bigger hype on the wait time? GTA 6 or Elder Scrolls 6?
Bro, that is one of the best questions I think you've ever asked.
I didn't hear it, and it still
because
sounded
both,
bad.
Both fan bases are large. I definitely think GTA is more popular, but there's a different kind. There's like
it's like GTA even non-gamers are aware of.
Yeah, everybody's been waiting for it.
Well, I think that's also
I definitely think GTA is more of a hype. Like only that, because it's more popular.
I think that's like it's popular like that's also due into the part to the nature of the franchise, which since day one has began it, you know. It's been controversial since day one, essentially.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yes, so you want me to play it? Oh yeah, and also so apparently this leaked. And so then they went and, like, right after the league, like, posted the 4K on the YouTube.
Yeah, because they were probably going to announce it at E3.
Yeah.
But everyone's been leaking it because people are fucking pissed, man. They want this fucking game. They're sick of waiting.
Nah, but you don't think that's fucked up that they leaked it and fucked their shit up?
I mean, Rockstar, what they've been doing is they've been sitting on GTA Online and releasing. They're doing exactly what
and
Bethesda
they just been
does.
Releasing DLC.
They're just re-releasing shit constantly. Bro, they released Red Dead Redemption 1 on the Switch, the PS3 port. They didn't even remaster it. And they fucking full priced it. We already talked about this. Like, they're just sitting on what makes them money, but it's the same game for the past decade.
It's ridiculous.
It's like, fuck you, give me the next one. It shouldn't have been this long.
That's what she said.
All right, let's get it. Damn, the quality sucks, boy.
Lucia, do you know why you're here?
Bad luck, I guess.
Yeah. Start it over.
She tried to make my world the way she thought it should be. Yeah, we were desperate then to have each other to fall. But love is a long, long road. Yeah, love is a long, long road.
Who's back? The only way we're gonna get through this is by sticking together, being a team. Trust?
Trust.
You gotta watch it. You gotta watch it on your phone so you can see the full resolution.
There's one simple vision hack anyone can use to improve vision. So you can say goodbye to your optometrist for good. Did you know that vision impairments have nothing to do with
your eyes?
Why
motherfucker put a spoon in his eyes?
What was he doing?
I like rusty spades.
No matter what type of glasses you wear or what eye treatments you try.
What was he doing with the spoons?
Look at that guy. What a fucking nerd.
Hey, four eyes.
Will become harder.
I have glasses too. I'm just kidding.
You gotta watch that trailer again on your phone on 4K. So no. You could see it.
No.
What impressed me with the trailer,
we just watched it in 4K.
Yeah, but on what we're watching right now, it was like blocky. It was like 30 frames.
I need Genshin Impact.
What impressed me about that trailer, if you look at the density of the buildings, like if you pause it, it's crazy. It feels like you're literally in a city. Like, GTA has always felt like that.
It doesn't feel like a visual facade.
No, yeah, it doesn't feel like a background almost. Like, it feels like an actual fucking city. Also, if you look at the beach, that little beach scene with when they're walking, there's so many fucking people on that beach that they're really pushing this next-gen shit.
Oh, yeah.
To where it's going to be, bro, I already know even a PS5 is going to be running really hard.
Yeah, bro, like the graphics... Are parts like imperceptible from, you know, it could be a straight up video.
Yeah, that's why you have to watch it again. Cause when I was watching it, like when it was showing the buildings and whatnot, it looks real. It doesn't look.
Yeah. We're getting there.
And so they've confirmed like the state. Cause I already looked at some breakdown. So like the license plate of the car, that's the cheetah car. Or whatever.
Yeah. The Ferrari.
This is in Vice City, so you can see on the license plate, like the state is Leonida. So like, you know, and let me tell you. So like, it's already like this is like the in universe version of Florida, right?
Yeah.
You know the way what's the LA one? Santa
Los Santos.
Los Santos, and then you know Liberty City.
Vice City. Liberty City is New York, and Vice City is Miami.
And so the state is Leonida. Like, let me tell you something. I've seen a lot of negative stuff too, mostly on IGN. I think that's where all the negative people gather to fester together and post negativity is in IGN comments specifically. But let me tell you.
It caught Florida's vibe 100%.
100%. Yeah, they captured the essence so well. And because some people were like, why are the women shaped like that? Like, they don't understand
Miami.
How accurate this shit is.
I was like, that bitch, she looks like a normal bitch in Miami.
Yeah.
Type
big
shit.
Old ass.
She looked good. She looked fake, but she looked good.
Bro, and the fucking booty cheek physics, bro.
Yeah.
Like, if you have to watch it, you have to watch it because, like, I'm not kidding you, bro. The fucking ass cheek jiggling. I'm like,
how
this
much
is one of the best physics I've seen.
It's going to come out for the
PS5?
I'm
going to guess that it's going to sell for $70.
It's going to come out on PS5?
PS5, Xbox Series X.
When's PS6 coming out?
Honestly, the PS5 has already been out for, like, almost 5 years. Maybe even 5 years now.
I might get a PS5.
They're cheap now.
How much?
400's the cheapest. 350, you can find them. It's worth it, bro. They're insane. There's literally no loading screens. You press a game, and like 26 seconds, you're playing that shit. And on the PS4, if there's like a loading screen, that doesn't exist on the PS5.
No, that's pretty sick.
Yeah.
All right, I'll get it. Fine. I'll ask my wife for it.
For the PS5?
Yeah.
Yeah, Matt, you need to get one for sure.
I mean, I'm pretty happy right now with the 4.
I have a 3 and it's barely working. And the Switch is like fucking... It's fun.
It's outdated.
It's fun, but it fucking blows.
You need a different experience because like... Playing on a PS5, when it comes to the frames, graphics, the responsiveness, the controller is so crazy. It feels like it's crazy to even... Okay, so imagine you're playing Call of Duty, right?
Mm-hmm.
It has adaptive triggers. So, like, each weapon has a different dead zone. Like, in real life, when you're pressing a trigger, once you actually activate it, there's recoil in the trigger.
Oh, wow.
When you're playing Spider-Man... You'll like, there'll be a dead zone, and once you press and he like activates the web shooter, it like sucks in almost like an actual web shooter. And on the right side of the controller, it feels like it's doing this and then this.
Oh, wow.
It's ridiculous. And it's like, I forgot exactly the technology that they use in it, but it's like liquid. Like the vibrations through the entire
instead
controller.
Of the gyroscope.
Yeah.
So this is a page I follow, DJ Academics Hairline.
Yeah, all the...
And showing some of the side-by-side from the IRL events that...
Then they put the Joker 305. Yeah,
I saw that shit. I saw that shit. I was like, oh, my God.
Whoa, that side score on the laptop is crazy. That shit went...
Just press the arrow.
Yeah, I just saw it, Sean. I just saw it.
Nice.
Oh yeah, like in the news, in the GTA trailer, like it says there's a headline with a Leonida man. And you know they had the alligator in the trailer. I'm not even sure like which one's the trailer and which one's the video.
That one's my favorite one. The two hammers.
Out of this neighbor, and I got you on video that you're destroying my car.
I remember.
Thank you.
This is like during the pandemic, right?
Out of this neighbor, and I got you.
Gator bites, yeah, apparently. Can't
blame the guy. Maybe. Who the fuck owns two hammers? You only need one hammer.
Popka police were on the
scene. Akimbo hammers. Dude, that should be
Rockstar
a movie.
Rockstar Dev spending hours watching twerking footage to get the perfect in-game dynamics.
That's what I mean, bro. Yes. Yo, I didn't even think about that. The fucking radio. Oh, the radio.
Oh, yeah.
So they also leaked, like, physics in the game. So apparently you can commit a crime, and it's not like the old GTA where it's instantly going to have a wanted rating. Like, you can commit a crime days past in-game. They start investigating... And then chasing you.
Ah, fuck yeah.
You gotta actually get caught.
And like stolen cars and all that, they'll take down license plates.
Like, bro, do
like it's crazy.
Do you see where everything is headed with chips in the brain, the metaverse, the video games getting more and more realistic. You know, GTA 7, we're gonna be living in it. That's gonna be real life.
Well, also, the map of this shit is insane. Did you see the map I showed Carlos earlier?
Yeah.
Compared to GTA 5?
It's like he says from Far Lauderdale down to the Keys.
The first key.
Dude, motherfuckers is going to be
canceling. And the Everglades.
When that drops, motherfuckers going to be canceling plans.
Oh, I'm definitely. I'm definitely. Shit. I might take out PTO for that. For like a full 2 weeks.
You guys get PTO?
He gets 1 week.
I'll save it for 2 years.
How many weeks do you get?
Zero.
You're a liar.
I'm not a W-2 employee. Liar. I don't get those benefits.
Damn.
What are you?
I'm a 1099 employee. I'm subcontracted through my LLC.
Damn, bro. I kind of want to watch that trailer again.
Yeah, dude.
Yo, Sean's going hard for this shit right now. They should hire you, bro.
I really can't. I can't express enough how much.
So
like,
when is it coming out?
2025.
Why?
They rushed the trailer because it was leaked. They were going to send or show it at the E3 trailer, which would have been a lot closer in like 2024.
I mean, bro, it's really a year away. Like 2023
it's gonna, done. It's going to be gone. 2023
is done. It's basically 2024.
Man, it's going to be forever. All right, but I could get a PS5.
Yeah, by then you'll have it and you'll like get used to it.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Get used to a PS5.
It's just different having it around, you know? I haven't gotten used to it.
Dude, you guys can tell like there's only two things in this world that Sean takes seriously. And that's cryptocurrency and video games.
Yeah.
It's very
not crypto anymore, definitely not.
No, I heard you guys talking before the pod, like, you were going ham, and you never go that ham about anything.
I guess, no, there's a lot of things. I mean, there's a lot of things I'm interested in, but mainly video games. I haven't been, like, on my crypto shit in a long time, but I did go through a period where I was, like, actively studying it more than anything else.
You were, like, at that time when shit was popping, you were that quintessential crypto person.
What should I get? Should I get the console? Slim console?
You should just get the digital console with two controllers. Because if you get it in the bundle with two controllers, each controller is $100. It actually might be more now. I think it might be like 120.
Like extra controllers, not the controller that comes with it.
Yeah, the controller comes with it. But if you get the one with two controllers, it's cheaper than buying a separate controller.
Because that's not what Apple would do. Apple would sell you a console, and then like you got to buy the controller separate. About?
Okay, go to Best Buy and look at PS5. With the two controllers, it's $670.
Yeah. $689.
On Best Buy?
$719.
Okay, then just look up the PS5 digital. Get the single.
Yo, they just had a sick bundle for Black Friday. That shit was $500 flat with Spider-Man included. Spider-Man 2.
But that's what I mean. No, they make the regular PS5 with a single controller. I saw it for $350 on Amazon.
It's supposedly like $550. That's like the one that's got all the...
$550. That's not bad. In another universe.
Right here, there's the Sony PS5 $440.
No, but not the Sony one. I want the other one.
What?
The Xbox?
Yeah, the Z-Box.
You might be looking at the Slim. That's the brand new one.
They want.
Oh yeah, they did just drop the Slim.
I just want to play.
He probably is looking at the Slim.
I just want to play video games.
Yeah, these are all the Slim.
Dude, your cat's hanging out in your drawer, and it's awesome.
I can't. He's like in the drawer.
Yeah.
Oh shit, he is. That's great.
There's one right here for $337 at Walmart.
Damn, let's get it,
bye. Bro. That's so worth it. $370.
Add to cart.
$399.
Get it.
I'm going to save up for it.
Digital edition $332.
All right, let's focus. You can.
Sorry, that fucked me up, man. GTA, fucking god damn. I mean, imagine like, because have you played GTA 5?
All right, that's enough of this shit.
Hold up. All no, right. Fuck off. Have you played GTA 5, Matt?
You know, I still haven't played it.
I beat it.
It like mimicked LA perfectly. Even people that lived in LA were like, yo, this is crazy because that's, you know, bubblegum shrimp.
I haven't even played GTA 4.
What?
The last one I played was 3.
Nah, 5 is sick.
Because
I have GTA 5 on PlayStation. Play it.
Yeah, I know. I've seen it.
It's a great story.
I've seen it. I've been working my way up to it.
Yeah. Imagine like visiting your place in this game.
What?
I don't think it's literally gonna have like your. I'm talking about like your home, like your neighborhood. Because it has Lauderdale to the Keys.
Yeah, your house is gonna be in it.
Allegedly.
What's your address? So everybody go look for it.
Matt's an NPC and everything. He's like, yo, y'all didn't pay me, bro.
I was watching something. It was Spider-Man. And the dude like took a video out his window and then took a screen recording of the game. And it was like the same, like they got this shit so accurately in New York. It was like the same exact. The landscape was like nearly identical.
Well, you know, like those Google cars, right?
Yeah, yeah.
They use info from that now. It used to be like actual engineers and shit would come and plot out whole maps that look similar, but now they use actual.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. Fucking so excited. All right, I'm done talking about it.
No, keep talking about it. Get it all out.
No,
we never have to hear about it again. No, I'm just kidding.
No, I want to talk about favorite Christmas songs.
Baby, it's cold outside. That little duet.
The one with Ariana Grande.
And everyone canceled it because they said it was rapey. Fucking pussies.
Wait, what?
Everyone said it was like a song about like...
Wait, which song?
Baby, it's cold outside. Baby, it's cold outside. Wait. Yeah. Maybe it's cold outside.
Oh yeah, it's not that rapey, but I think I remember the incident. Well, I think I remember hearing about that. My Silver Bells.
Silver bells.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah, that one instantly reminds me of Home Alone.
They play that in Home Alone?
Maybe not, but it just does.
Okay.
It's a Home Alone type beat.
What about you? What about you, Carlos?
Donnie Hathaway, This Christmas. I think we've gone through this before.
This Christmas.
I gave you my heart. In the very
no.
next
No, dude, you went through the same way. We have to play both of these episodes back to back because we went through the same exact thing.
I'm getting a little bit deja vu.
Yeah, I was like, this Christmas
will
be a very special Christmas for me. Shake a hand.
Oh, you know I'm fucking up too because even it goes Last Christmas, not This Christmas. You know that my favorite Christmas movie though is Last Christmas with Emilia Clarke.
It's no, like the Die Hard. Die Hard's the best Christmas movie.
It is a good one.
I'll give you that. That's valid.
I think the best Christmas movie.
Hey, maybe we'll hang out, have a couple beers.
Okay, but if you guys want to have a good cry, you got to watch The Last Christmas.
We had this exact conversation last year.
She's
on the train or whatever. And
fuck
she's
all that.
Person,
Jim Carrey's The Grinch is the best Christmas movie.
That's valid.
What happened to goddamn game? It crashed. Fuck this Xbox. It's about time. We're outdated, fellas.
Yeah, you gotta get a PlayStation 5, Slim.
You get a fucking PS5.
Yo, put on Grand Theft Auto. What the fuck?
Yeah, but it's 4.
You don't have 5?
I do, but I'd have to download.
Oh, but you know what?
No, put 4. I'm gonna start
downloading it and we'll play it.
You know, I guess
time.
I haven't played 5.
What?
I beat 4, but I don't think I've played 5.
Where you're like you're in a heist of bank robbers and you could switch between Trevor, Franklin, and Michael.
Okay, yeah.
I beat three. Yeah. I've never played 4 or 5.
What's 4?
4 is Nico Bellic.
Oh, yeah. Fuck
and Liberty
that one.
City.
That's, yeah, fuck that. That one's
yo, it has better
yo,
physics.
I used to have Chinatown on my iPod Touch.
Me too.
You remember that when you had the app? You could, bro, yeah.
That shit was awesome.
Because that was the year I dropped out of school, and I just spent the first 3 months where I actually did go to class, like, just playing that game just all, like, until lunch, and I just left school.
They banned the first GTA, right? Because it was, like, you would actually have to scale out shit and
taught
kids how to scale out drugs.
Yo, you just reminded me. I know it's something. I was going to say, so the trailer's been getting some backlash. People have been... Because there's a female lead in the game. You see where I'm going with this?
Yeah. People are fucking freaking
people
out.
People saying GTA 6 is
sold out. All that bullshit. But it looks like a fucking badass love story.
It like, yeah, first of all, yeah, it does. But hold on.
Whoa there.
These fucking incels, bro. Let women have some wins, dog. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, bro. I love women.
I want to play this game with my girlfriend.
The last game, like, it was like someone that like looked like me with the, you know, some bald white dude and like a dirty tank top.
Talking about Trevor.
but God forbid you got fucking plays that fucking hot ass chick in those jean shorts.
Yeah, bro. Honestly, every time I played GTA Online, I played as a female so I could just look at the ass.
And so, okay, so woke is a conservative diss, right? Like, that's something the conservatives say
as a diss, yeah.
So, bro, we talking about
practice, not a game, not a game. All right, go
practice.
Ahead. That's something I'm just willing to go out and die for.
Practice,
yeah.
This game has been like on. Like the conservative hit list since day one, like I'm pretty sure they've gone to Congress about this shit. Like you were saying, you know, ban this, that, and the third, and so now you're worried about this game being woke.
Fucking losers.
Okay. I'm not gonna go through all the hassle to bring this up on the screen. Okay, so I'm in the comments from when IGN. Damn, bro, I've been fucking the whole episode. so IGN posted the trailer and I was going through the comments and I saved it. At Connecting Amazing People said, when are people going to realize that men don't want to be girls? So let me click on his profile. John Patrick Mueller.
I know a bunch of men that want to be
conscious
girls.
Leadership coaching for New Earth executives. What the fuck is New Earth?
Hey yo, this server right here outdated. Hey yo, can I get an update on this server real quick?
What game is this?
Left 4 Dead.
Damn, maybe I should. Maybe I now I kind of do want to hook this up, the HDMI. But
damn, I want to hook up too.
His fucking profile.
Well, I don't think we can keep blasting people's Instagram profiles, dude.
Yo, he posted his girlfriend and she got some hard nips. Sorry, because he tagged her. I had to go on her profile. Okay, wait. I'm going to get lost my train of thought. So then, he got the health and wellness coach thing going on. So then, Satan's underscore homeboy was like, not a very, quote unquote, health and wellness take of you. And he just wrote back, look at your name.
What's your name?
Okay, that is not very funny. It's like you had to be there thing. Like, the way I'm looking at it, it's funny.
Yeah, no, for sure. I love it. Thank you.
Okay, wait. Okay, so now, okay. So, Connecting Amazing People is clapping back to some people. So, to reminder, his initial comment was, when are people going to realize that men don't want to be girls? So, he says, I don't play any video games at all. And in general,
what the fuck are you doing?
What the fuck are you on IGM's Instagram, bro? And in general, men like to fantasize about being better men.
Wow, this guy's a fucking square.
Yeah,
he sounds homophobic because he truly does love penis. <He's> a, that's the kind of person that. And he's like, no, I would never suck a dick. Oh, never! Yo, me? 100 grand.
Yo, I like how his fucking clapback about how men don't want to be girls has to do with men fantasizing about, in any context, about men.
Yeah.
Men like to fantasize about being better men.
No,
which is why video games and superhero movies exist.
He meant better in men.
Like women don't exist. He's just basically saying like women.
I'm starting to think his girlfriend pic that he posted isn't real, because then he's responded to someone else. He said I actually married a 22-year-old Moroccan supermodel virgin. Nice try.
What also the fuck?
Body count over 50. Many of them model worthy. A bunch of emojis. What else you got? Yo, this guy's gotta
please,
be troll.
Let me see what this guy looks like, please. Please, man. Yo, the internet needs to be canceled completely, dude.
Someone responded to him saying, so you fantasize about better men?
So wait, does there a picture of his wife? The supermodel?
Yeah, that's the one with the hard nips I was talking about.
Oh, but is that really her? Are they together?
I don't know. There's no pictures of them together.
What does he look like?
Also, her profile look.
What does this guy look like? He's like Steven Seagal status. This guy. Do you know the story of Steven Seagal?
He's fucking insane, bro. I've been flying choppers for like 25 years.
No,
you know why they call it a Skippy? Because when it flies away, it goes skip, 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 skip.
There was there's a
Tom Segura.
Wait. So someone wrote a big paragraph to him talking about Spider-Man is a male, so you can see yourself as him. And so he wrote back to that person,
I'm him.
Oh wait, no, I can't find it.
You had to be there in the comment section. It was wild. I remember that day.
These comments are going brazy.
What's brazy mean?
Crazy.
It's just crazy with a B.
Like it's the blood's version of crazy, because I can't say B. You know?
So anybody could just say that and there won't be any consequences?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think by now it's just been accepted that people are on gang time.
All right, so the dude 89 said 20 years ago conservatives hated GTA for its adult content. Now they're calling it woke. You guys make me laugh. So at Better Call Hull said you
it's a good name though.
You retarded as fuck if you think I'm saying it's woke because of a female lead. Okay, Sean. What else about that trailer? What could possibly be? Sean, you've
the ass cheeks?
That's woke?
No. That would be considered derogatory, whatever the fuck, you know what I mean? Like towards women, like strip clubs.
So someone else responded to that person said,
"That's what Miami's all about."
You have Miami.
You have legit grown men whining about playing with a female lead as if there's never been games with female lead characters before. Imagine if they had been around when the original Metroid was released.
The Omigital.
It's the Omigital.
I used to play Tomb Raider.
Tomb Raider is the shit.
Was released, beat the game in the biggest shock of their lives when they found out they were controlling a woman lead the whole time.
Damn.
So now someone's projecting back. They said, I don't see conservatives complaining anywhere, to be honest. Sounds like you are projecting because this game looks like a woke liberal's nightmare.
What?
Man. What? I think I'm going to delete my Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram, every single comment section I've been on recently is just...
Here, look, I'm just going to go on any...
Here's
I'm
the thing, I think there's a strong correlation, because right now, they say the stats show that reading comprehension is at an all-time low, at least in America. And I'm going to say this again and again, okay, because I think I'm right about this. They should make comment sections, especially on Instagram. Like, not necessarily for, like, a text-based service or even, like, YouTube comments, but Instagram comments. You should have to, first of all...
Instagram?
Instagram.
You were saying Instagram.
Instagram. They should make Instagram comment.
Hey, yo, you know that Instagram?
You know, man, Instagram. They should make Instagram comments. You should have to prove you're a human every single time you want to make a comment. It would be a deterrent to these people flagrantly, incessantly posting bullshit. If you had to move the tiles around every time you want to post a comment, I think that would slow it down. And also, too, that would solve the fucking bot problem. There's a huge bot problem on social media. Every time you post, you should have to prove you're a human.
Yeah, all I get fucking sad whenever I get a new follower. It's always like a bot. And it's like a woman in her bio. It says, 22-year-old fucking come lick my pussy. Like some crazy shit. It's like, bro, does nobody really care about my personality?
At @ThemosWolf_Wolf, who I'm looking at his backup account is Punished Wolf. And his bio says, Crisis Lord. Female main character is going to be a massive L for this game, calling it now.
Hey, Last of Us 2 was a female lead. How was that game? I had two female leads.
And people tear that apart.
People have destroyed that game's like integrity because
the game was amazing. We're gonna talk about it next week for sure. I know we've been meaning to talk about
it. How do I play it?
PS4, PS5.
It's worth it.
The
PS5's exclusives are worth it, bro.
This dude Eric J said, not really wanting a female protagonist. Will she get crazy like Trevor every 25 days or so? Rockstar went woke and nerfed Trevor in GTA 5. This is going to be a false promise like Cyberpunk.
All right, I don't even want to hear any more of these. It's kind of like
no, bro. You got to get triggered like I got triggered.
No, bro.
Feel what I feel.
Fuck all that. Just ignore it. People
you're sitting
suck.
There like, oh, fuck this. I keep reading. Ah, fuck them. Yeah. I hate this.
No,
keep
people
reading.
Fucking suck, bro. Like
this person said, why is every woman shaped like Kim Kardashian? That's just someone. That's Florida.
Miami.
Man. That's Florida, man.
What's Miami?
Kim Kardashian. Ha ha. Why were you angry? What was angering you?
Shitty comments.
About GTA?
It's not even about necessarily GTA. It's about how fucking stupid people are. It just makes me like lose hope in the average fucking human.
You heard it from him, guys. From Shrooms to Skyrim with Shawn.
Fuck you guys.
Lost faith in humanity. This guy.
Look, let me tell you, I've been lost faith in humanity. Okay, I think good.
But that's why I don't want to like watch that shit, and I'd rather just be around good humans.
So this person said, "I just think this character duo was a poor choice. When I was 10 years younger, I was amazed by the GTA 5 protagonist trio, and I would be today. But not even to an 8-year-old kid, I don't believe these two would be attractable." Which I'm pretty sure is not a word.
Attractable?
Attractable.
Retractable.
What are we, fucking magnets?
I don't think these two would be attractable.
I don't think these two would be attractor.
Bro, a lot of these comments though are good. Like, the city looks massive. Rockstar so far ahead of other developers is scary.
A lot of people don't also give flowers to Red Dead 2 is like, because everyone's focused on GTA. Red Dead 2 was a masterpiece.
Red Dead.
That game was fucking alive. It was so weird to play because there were so many different things. Like, the game was alive is the best way I could put it.
Was the game dead or
nah, bro? That shit was. what's the antonym to that?
The antonym. Is that the Breathman?
Do you know
company?
That? Do you know that word?
Oh, here's the comment I was looking for that I was reading earlier today, from Ephraim Vids.
I don't like it already.
Oh man, I love when these people got these public profiles for me to go.
You're stupid.
So he said, "Bruh, f this." .. Only reason I won't play this game is because it's led by a female character. ..
Bro.
Not a fan of that.
People like this exist.
Then someone responded to him, and oh, this person's from Miami, Florida. R. Hazard. He said, "You play as the boyfriend Jason as well." This dude responded to him, "Still. .. And then not an emoji, but when you put the slash next to the two dots, like, you know, before you had emojis and you had to make faces with punctuation.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I'm not going to lie. I still do that shit.
The week is a semicolon. The winking face is a semicolon.
Yo, I used to go ham with the winky face, bro.
And the parentheses? No, my favorite is the colon with a V.
What time
with the greater than sign, and it looks like.
What time we at, Matt?
Okay, so
we're at an hour.
Is it an hour or is it like an hour 25?
It's an hour 8. What are you trying to say?
Just making sure.
The fuck are you trying to say?
Yo, fuck him
It was
up.
Like 1 week you were like an hour 20 and then that shit was an hour 49 minutes.
We'll probably
of you just talking about fucking Marvel for an hour and 49 minutes.
That's the whole basis of this podcast.
Yeah,
and I'll do it again.
I can't believe you did that to
Yo,
us,
Matthew,
bro.
You know what, dude? Stick up for yourself, man. I like that shit. Hey, yeah, fuck you, Shawn. Matthew.
Fuck you.
Yo, we talking about video games this whole podcast. You'll see me. Oh my God, we talking about video games for 45 minutes.
We did not talk about it this whole time.
Yes, we have.
I talked about it for like 15 minutes, bro. We're like,
from Shrooms to Skyrim. You heard it first, guys. We're fighting.
We've been talking about it for the past 40 minutes.
I don't believe that.
Bro, look at what I'm downloading.
Fake news.
Look what I'm downloading.
What are you downloading?
You guys can see it for sure. No. It says.
What are you downloading? Genshin?
What if it was like his social security information?
It's only 25,000 megabytes.
Wait, are you really downloading it?
25,000?
Yes. 25 gigs. All right, guys. Why didn't you hurt? I don't know.
Alright, so
yo, that shit sounded like you were like, like the computer was crashing.
I actually keep having to. I'm gonna stop looking at comment sections for public stuff. No, I'm lying. I'm not gonna stop.
Yeah, yeah. Send me everything. I want to see it.
Let's just start beef with average people. Fuck famous people. Yo, you fucking, yeah, fuck you.
Just start DMing them. Yo.
DM them the episodes, like.
Like, clip like, it and be like, yo.
Everybody, shame them.
Yo, you know how brazy that would look? Like,
that would be crazy. Like, that might be like a whole new genre of podcast.
Like showing someone, like it's a video of like their profile, and it's just like our thumbnails at both corners, and we're just talking shit about them. You know what kind of beef that would start?
Let's do it.
Yo, like I would.
We should call it like the fuck face of the week.
Man, yeah, yeah, that's a good idea. New bet. That's a new bet.
Cause like there's like a whole thing in the podcast industry. Like it's like the like Rory and Mal, like they call it pod wars. Like they be having like little beef with other podcasts and talking shit about each other. But this like would be like a whole nother level of that. This is like real person.
Yeah, it's like, bro, you just suck. You just.
Well, yeah, we'll make fun of them.
Man, that's
we'll really bully them. We're gonna bully them via podcast. Haven't you heard?
Wait. Yeah! You want to hear that song?
That's what we used to do. Right?
No, that's the intro.
Yo, I can't.
No, but that used to be the outro too.
No.
Yo, I must have changed the button. I can't get it to stop. I got to stop.
Bro, right? The intro used to be the outro.
Never. When? You thought I was going to agree with you? I'm not.
Bro, what's up with you today? You're just like doing your own thing.
Bro.
Yeah, he's like, fuck you guys.
Yeah, what's going on?
What does that mean? I'm doing my own thing. What does that mean? What does that fucking mean?
And like that, like right there, like
no.
Yo, Carlos, just keep ignoring. Haven't you heard? Yo, we have to clip the David Blaine shit to put on Instagram.
I don't even know what episode that was, but it was amazing.
Is this your card? What is the name? Your parents died in a car crash when you were younger. I know this.
Yo, what if he was like somebody's life insurance agent?
Oh, that's a bit.
And
right
then
there.
Like, and then
that's like a whole skit right there.
Yeah. He's like, so here in your dad's will. He's like reading He's the like, will. He's like, here, read this. The guy picks it up and it's like, is that your card?
Yeah, no. Or like you're in a car crash and he's an adjuster and he grabs a piece of glass and he puts it through his hand. He's like, hopefully we can cover this. All right.
Cake man.